in a far-off kingdom.
More than anything,
there lived a young maiden, a sad young lad,
more jewels,
I wish,
and a child disfigured.
More than life,
I wish,
with his wife.
More than anything,
more than the moon, I wish. The king was giving a festival.
More than life, I wish.
Wish to go to the festival.
More than riches.
The food.
I wish my cow would give us some milk.
More than anything,
I wish we had a child.
Taken for his new wife.
The festival.
A woman with two daughters of her own.
Look at your nails,
look at your dress.
People would laugh at you. Nevertheless, you do is to go to the festival and dance before the priest. Ha, 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 ha.
All three were beautiful of face, but vile and black of heart. Jack, on the other hand, had no father, and his mother,
I wish.
Well, she was not quite beautiful.
I wish my mom would not.
I have to go into the wood. Time is old. I must begin my
tired.
What's the good of being good if everyone is blind and you're always left behind? Mama, we're blind, Cinderella, kind Cinderella. Nice, good night, kind, good night.
Because the baker had lost his mother and father in a baking accident, well, at least that's what he believed, he was anxious to have a family of his own and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Who might that be?
We have sold our last loaf of bread.
Oh, it's the witch from next door! We have no bread!
Of course you have no bread!
Well, what do you wish?
It's not what I wish, it's what you wish.
Nothing baking in that oven now, is there?
The old enchantress went on to tell the couple that she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a maid, your father brought his young wife to this cottage. They were a handsome couple.
Well, not handsome maid!
You see, your mother was a child. She developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father what she wanted more than anything. Was
greens, greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, celery, asparagus, and watercress, and fiddlefire, and lettuce. He said, all right, but it wasn't quite, because I caught him in the yard in my garden one night. He was robbing me, raping me, running through my rutabaga, running my arugula, and ripping up my rippy and my chimney and my paper, and I should have ran a spell on him right. Get out! Put him in a stone!
Oh,
I do!
Go to the wood and bring me back one, the cow as white as milk, two,
Sue the cape as red as blood. Free the hair as yellow as corn. Fall the slipper as pure as gold. Bring me these before the time of midnight. In 3 days' time, and you shall have, I guarantee, the child as perfect as child can be. Go to the wood!
Go!
Ladies, have carriage, please.
Now may I go to the festival?
The festival? Darn those nails, darn those clothes, and lint of a fussy but darn with those. You make us the rules of the festival, and walk if I the prince. The carriage is waiting. You must be gone.
Good night. I wish.
Look what I found in Father's hunting jacket.
6 beans.
Yes, yes, I wonder if they're the witches. No, you are not coming.
I know you're fearful of the woods at night.
No, the spell is on my house. Only I can lift the spell.
No,
the spell
is on my house. We must lift the spell.
No, you are not coming. That is the fine. Now, what was I to return with?
I don't remember. The cow is white, milk, the cake is red. What? The hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
The cow is white, milk, the cake is red. Blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure.
And so the beggar reluctantly set off to meet the enchantress's demands.
I still wish to go to the festival.
But
how am I ever to get to the festival? I know of all the inns and small ones, free the grain of the hazel tree. And tell her I just want to go to the king's festival. To the woods, it's time to go. Maybe you'll remain, I know. Into the woods, but even so, I have to take the journey. Into the woods, the path is straight, I know.
Time, Jack?
No, sir.
Is that the truth?
Well, you see, now I'm resting.
How much are you asking for this animal? No more or less four, less than 5 pounds.
Okay, okay, what's such a sum?
Well, my mother told me I should sell.
Your mother? A boy your age? Why, you'd like to accept her for a second being.
Well, I have to listen to my mother.
Sir?
Come along, Milky Way. There are spirits here.
Good day, young lady.
Good day, Mr. Wolf.
Is it a very sudden? Good.
Tell my grandmother's.
And what might be in your basket?
Red wine, but it isn't a great rich call.
And where much of the ground will there live?
A big one will lead right into the woods. Her house doesn't look very large oak tree.
You've no business being in the woods alone. You've no idea what I've come upon. You would be speared for
What are you doing with a cow in the middle of the woods? I was headed toward market,
but I seem to have lost my way here.
What are you planning to do then?
What are you planning to do then?
Sell my cow, sir. No less than £5.
Fuck! Where am I to get £5?
She must be generous enough to fetch £5.
Yes, ma'am.
And if you can't fetch that sum, then what are you to do?
I hadn't thought of that. I suppose my mother and I will have no food to eat.
This is the sum total.
Beans. Oh! We mustn't give up our beans! Well, if you feel we must.
Huh?
Beans will bring you food, son.
Beans? In exchange for my cow?
These are no ordinary beans. These beans carry magic.
Magic? What kind of magic?
Magic that defies description.
My mother wouldn't approve of
you. You can use your turn to attack me.
How many beans?
Six.
Oh, fine. We mustn't part with them all. We need one for ourselves. Besides, I'd say they're worth at least a pound each.
Could I buy my cow back someday?
Well, possibly. Good luck there, young lad.
I guess this is goodbye.
Thank you. tomorrow before that whole witch rise. I shall stand beneath her tower and ask her to let down her hair.
Hello, little girl.
Hello.
I hope you saved some sweets for Granny.
I ate all the sweets. And half
a loaf of bread. Well, nonetheless, this is one very beautiful cake you have. I so admire it.
My granny made it for me.
Oh, is that right? I wish I had a cake like this.
You look pretty foolish.
Do you mind if I just take a look at it?
Oh, I left it with cake, sir. Leave it in the bag.
Oh, but I want it badly.
Get it there, sir. Where'd you go, little girl? And get the cake.
I just wanted to make sure that you really, really loved that cake. Now, go along to Granny's and make sure no war comes your way.
I'm gonna whoop at you any day.
Oh, God. If you know what you need, then you go and you find it and you take it. Do I want a child or not? It's a cloak. What's a cloak? It's a joke. It's a stupid little cloak. But a cloak is what you make it. So you take it. Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them more.
And so the beggar, feeling more determined than ever, ran through the woods in search of the cloak. As for the little girl, she continued her journey, hindered neither by beggar nor by wolf. Until she came upon the gingerbread man, who despite running as fast as he could, still became Red Riding Hood's snack in the wood. When she reached her destination, however, the little girl was surprised to find her grandmother's cottage door standing open.
Oh dear! How uneasy I feel! Perhaps it's all I had been so careful.
big night.
Than he'd ever felt, ran back through the woods. As for the lad Jack,
only a building stands at home with me!
Mother! No!
Ow! The tail's not suffering for you!
Grow into an enormous star that would stretch into the heavens.
Thank you.
low in the world, you better than things you know in the world, and grant it up to show you just how small you are. You wave up high to run your own in the world, like now that you ever know the sky is lead, so you're free to do whatever pleases you. Exploring things you never dare, cause you don't care, and suddenly there's a big, fall, terrible giant at the door. Big, tall, terrible lady giant screaming for. And she gives you food and she gives you rest. And she draws you close to her giant breast. And you know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky. Well, we just made our friend and all. And you know she's big, but you don't feel small. We're bigger than her. Like the hall swallowed you for lunch. And your heart is lead, your stomach's stone, and you're really scared being all alone. And instead of too long for the things you've known in the world, you left and the money you found not fun is done. You stay what you can and run. You scramble down and you look up all the world. You know it's the road. Your house and your mother at the door.
Ha 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 ha!
I'm sorry I lost the cow.
I'm sorry if I yelled, but would you please just return home? I will make things right. Then we can just go about our lives. No more hunting through the woods for strange objects, or dim-witted boys, and hungry little girls, and witches. Now, would you please just go?
I've been searching all night for her. Her, the beautiful one I danced evening with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared, like the fine morning mist.
She was lovely?
The loveliest.
I am not certain of that. For I too have found a maiden. She lives here, in the woods.
The woods?
Yes, atop a tower that has no doors or stairs.
Where?
As soon as you hear this bell, you must know.
And how do you manage your visit?
I stand in your tower and say, Rapunzel! Rapunzel! Let down your hair to me. And she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellowest corn, which I collect.
Rapunzel! Rapunzel! What kind of name is that? You jest. I have never heard such a thing.
I speak the truth!
Say they're as true as your name. A maiden that was run from a prince. Never run from us.
Yes, one has. Did I abuse her, show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Be a power of speech when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
On her tower she sits by the hour maintaining her hair. By the coming and dreams becoming alive aware.
What's out of reach? Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I am, so man as you are grown
on everything made for
one of mine? The girl must be mine.
Know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there as well.
Oh,
I have no children.
That's okay, too.
Well, I'm sorry, I'm not seeing your son today.
Oh, I hope he didn't go up the beanstalk again. Quit worrying your head, I say. Jack? Jack?
I suppose it will take the two of us to have this child.
you took five gold pieces.
Use the five gold pieces.
I didn't take. You gave.
Where are the five gold pieces?
An old man came by and said I could have my cow.
You take money, poor child.
I did not take Milky White is dead!
Two!
I gave you protection, and yet you disobeyed me.
No.
Why didn't you tell me you had a visitor? I will not share you, and I will show you worlds you've never seen.
I don't know. Leave me alone.
Well, haven't I left you all long enough?
Your questions make no sense, old man. Go away.
In need of another cow?
Stop and take stop while you're still.
something to do.
I've learned something too
that I never knew before.
In the land of the giants,
what?
You! Feed them to the cow!
Feel this.
I'll do it. She'll only go for me. Come on, squeeze, pal.
I insist!
And when Cinderella presented herself and tried on the blood-soaked slipper, it fit like a glove.
This is the true bride!
And much to the dismay of the stepmother and her sisters, Cinderella joined the Griffin Forest, riding off and talking to the bride. Until the day her prince, wandering aimlessly, heard a voice so familiar he went towards him. And when she saw him, Rapunzel, overjoyed, fell into his arms, weeping. Two of her tears wet his eyes and returned his vision.
Thank you.
Once upon a time. Later.
Oh.
Oh. I wish.
In the same far-off kingdom.
More than anything.
Lived a young princess.
Like
the lad Jack.
More than footmen.
I wish.
And the baker and his family.
No,
I wish.
More than anything.
More than normal. Time has come for a festival.
More than life.
I miss.
I wish to sponsor a festival.
More than rich in
and it. Cool.
I miss my kingdom up in the sky.
More than anything.
I wish we had more room.
Another room.
But despite some minor inconveniences, they were all content. Castle, but not before visiting Jack and his mother.
Oh!
baker!
The baker.
What can we do for you today, sir?
I am here to investigate the destruction that was brought upon our village today.
Jack has been with me all day.
The baker told them he feared there was a giant in their land.
I can recognize a giant's footstep. I can go to your house.
You don't know this name.
Well, ma'am, any help at all
would be great. Sorry, but you get none of us. No one cared when there was a giant. I paid for it. And I'll remember you volunteered to come to my
home. A giant in your backyard is one thing. A crushed home is quite another.
Look, young man, giants never strike the same house twice. I wouldn't worry.
Well, I'm taking the news to the castle nonetheless.
And when the baker reached the castle, it was the princess who greeted his news. The story unfolds.
Excuse me, ma'am. There's a small man. Let's insist on seeing you.
Princess, I'm here to report the sighting of a giant on land.
Where did you see a giant?
Well, I didn't exactly see the giant, but...
Then how do you know there's a giant in the land?
Well, there's footsteps everywhere, and our home was destroyed.
What? That could be any number of things. I shall show you to the door.
Wait!
Wait. Princess, there was a nearby household visited by a giant not long ago, descending from a beanstalk.
Yes, I remember.
And that giant was slain.
Wait, please. Princess, we have a young child. Our child was very hard to come by. His safety is of great importance to me.
I'll return now.
Yes.
I will be sure that the prince hears of this when he returns. Oh. I'm off to party today.
Goodbye, mother.
Now, I want you to stay inside.
You haven't been outside all day.
I don't want you now, mother. I've been a giant.
But I know how to kill a giant.
Please, we've had our fill of giants.
Mother, if I could help them out, I would.
Isa, I don't want you to leave your
But mother, I'm a man now.
There's still a boy in your mother's eyes, and I want you to promise.
I promise.
What happened to your house?
Oh, we had a baking accident.
A baking accident?
No, you frightened me up today.
You can't frighten her.
John.
Well, yes.
Huh? Father would not even have done that. It's work for your steward, or less.
Well, what brings you to the woods?
Her proposal has run off.
Run off?
Yes. She's a changed woman. She's been subject to hysterical fits of crying. And food sweet that no soul could predict.
What's a pity?
Oh, and Cinderella.
She remains well.
Does she now? Do tell me what your really doing.
Why, in a tower like yours, what must hire a beauteous sleep? All round the tower, there gets a briar 100 feet. When the one thing you want is a thing that you've not even seen.
Aye, from the casket entirely of glass, no is a wrinkle. Hence I don't ask it again, alas, just unwavable.
What unmistakable
agony is the way of his heart.
Yes, but even a cricket's my thing about blood
of its sick.
No sicker than your thing with dwarfs.
Dwarfs! Dwarfs are very upsetting.
Not forgetting our tasks unachievable. Looks unconceivable. It's conceivable. What a available.
The giant's a woman!
you hear me? We're the dumb giant.
No!
Found the boy. There was no consensus among them as to which course of action they should take.
Put a spell on her.
What? I have no powers, and if I did, do you think I would be here with all of you? We have to give her someone. The steward. It's his line of duty to sacrifice his life.
Ah! Don't be ridiculous! I'm not getting my life up from no one!
I'm waiting!
You must understand, these were not people familiar with making decisions. Their past experiences in the woods had in no way prepared them to deal with the force in this way. Sorry, I just tell the story. I'm not part of it.
That's right. It's not none of us.
You're always on the outside.
That's my role. There must always be an outside observer.
Now you're unified.
You're making a big mistake.
Nonsense.
There must always be an objective observer to pass the story along.
Some of us know it the way you're telling it.
No. Without me, you won't have no higher story ends. You'll be lost.
Wait a minute. He's right. He's the only one who knows how the story ends.
Oh, you think it'll be fun when you have to tell it yourself? Think of your child.
Oh, he's right. Let him go. Put that away.
No, that's better. You don't want to live in a world of chaos. There must always be an objective.
Your name is angry.
Claw our anger! Claw our love! Who been claw?
against the world, I meant. Couldn't you listen? Couldn't you stay content? Stay behind walls, as I could not. No matter what you say, children won't listen. No matter what you do, children refuse to learn. Guide them along the way, but still they won't listen. Children can only grow from something you love.
Of course.
Excuse me, ma'am. May I be of some service?
The tree has fallen. My mother's grave destroyed.
Oh, I'm sorry.
All of my wishes have just been crushed.
Oh, don't say that.
It's true. You wouldn't understand.
Well, you can't stay here. There's a giant on loose.
I'm sure that the prince will see to it that the giant is driven from our land.
Yeah, the prince. There's been no sign of the prince. He's probably off seducing some young maiden.
What?
I don't know. I just hear that's what princes do.
Not all princes.
You look just like the princess, only dirty. Oh, you are the princess. I'm sorry.
Get up. I'm not a princess here.
Well, what are you to do?
Well, I better make my way back to the castle.
Oh, you haven't heard? We came upon the royal family. The castle's been destroyed by the giant.
What about the prince?
There was no sign of him. Here, you must come with me. You'll be safe in our company.
Facts, find the boy, join the stop the giant, get out of these woods.
Now I understand, and it's time to leave the woods.
Hold on.
giant.
Maybe I shouldn't have strayed the path.
Maybe I shouldn't have attended the ball.
Yes, maybe you shouldn't have.
Where are you going?
Away from here.
What you say? Then we can have this together.
You don't understand. It doesn't matter if we're together or apart.
We need your help.
My wife was the only one who really helped. I depended on her for everything.
She would leave your child?
My child would be happier in the arms of a princess.
But wait!
Dead.
Not so quickly, are we ever?
As far as I'm concerned, you are.
Is that true?
It's because of you all of this happened.
Son, I went to that garden to get your mother a gift, and I foolishly took some of those pains for myself. How am I to know? How are we ever to know? And when your mother died, I ran away from my guilt. And now, are you going to save me?
No.
Are you going to save me?
No more questions, please. No more tests. Comes the day you say what for, please. No more.
You disappoint, you leave a mess, you die with people.
What?
You disappoint, and time here for the above
No more riddles. No more jests. No more curses you can't undo. Left by fathers you never knew. No more quests. No more feelings. Time to shut the door. Just no more.
Goodbyes, the reverses. Oh, those wonderful.
all the giants. No more. Give me my son. We must think of a plan before the giant returns.
What?
We must all think.
If there's just some way we could surprise her.
She's a top surprise. Oh, my friend! I need your help now more than ever.
What if the prince? It doesn't matter.
The matter is now that we need to find a way to fell the giant. Now, what can you do to help?
You can't do that.
Why not?
mother hears that I've slain the giant.
Jack, your mother is dead.
Dead? Was she killed by the giant?
No, no. She was arguing with the giant and was struck by the Prince's steward.
Oh no, why would he do that?
He thought she was provoking the giant.
Can no one bring her back?
No one.
That steward will pay for this. After we slay the giant, I will slay him.
He will do none of the kind.
But he shouldn't have killed my mother, right?
I guess not.
Then he must die.
Well, no.
Why not?
Because that would be wrong, Jack.
Well, he did what wrong.
He should be punished. He will be, somehow.
How?
I don't know. Stop asking me questions I can't answer.
I'm going to kill him.
Fine.
Kill him, then.
No. No, don't kill him.
The mother isn't here now.
Right things, right things.
Who knows what she'd say?
Who can say what's
true? Nothing's quite so clear now.
Things, right things.
You lost your way.
You decide what you are not alone.
Believe me, no one is alone.
No one.
Someone is on your side.
On our side.
Someone
go.
Boys and high know how to get there and how to get back.
And eat first.
The knife that is sharp today may be dull by tomorrow.
Oh. Now we can all just return home. Let us hope there'll be no more killing.
I have no one to take care of me.
You have to take care of yourself now, Jack. It's time.
No, it isn't. I'll take care of you.
You will?
Yes, I'll be your mother now.
I don't want another mother. I want
a friend.
And a pet.
Maybe I just wasn't meant to have children.
Don't say that. Of course you were meant to have children.
But how should I go about being a father with no one to mother my child?
Just calm the child.
Yes, calm the child.
Tell him the story of how it will happen. Be father and mother. You'll know what to do.
Alone.
Sometimes a spell may last
and it came to pass, all that seemed wrong was now right, and those who deserved to were certain to live a long and happy life. Ever after.
Ever after.
Journey over, all is mended, and it's not just for today, but tomorrow, and extended, ever after.
Ever after.
All the curses have been ended, the reverses wiped away, all is tenderness and laughter, for forever after. Dangers and confusion, and paths would often swerve. There were constant disillusions, but they never lost their nerve, and they reached the right conclusion.
And we got what we deserve.
Be careful, don't be clever, when you see your wish pursued.